Hey, Joey, my man, that pot was great last night, man. Oh, yeah. Oh, it was great. We got to get some more from you, man. Best pot I ever smoked, man. We smoked the whole thing up. Half pound only goes so far, you know what I'm saying? Oh, great party, Joey. Great party. You should have been there, man. Me and Frankie, we go down the corner, right? We kidnaps Louie. We brings him up to the apartment. We got 5 cases of beer, 3 cases of champagne, 5 bottles of Jack Daniels, 1 ounce of Coke, and 1/2 pound of pot, right? For the 3 of us, right? Louis looking around, he goes, what's all this? I go, what's all this? You're getting married tomorrow, man. Come on, it's your surprise stag party. Gotta party down one last time before we nail the coffin lid shut, right? He's looking around, Joey, he's looking around, he goes, yeah, well, I gotta be at the church at 10 a.m. I can't get too wasted, right? Frankie's cutting lines of coke. He hears that. He just looks up from the counter where he's cutting the coke, and he goes, don't worry, man. We won't get you too wasted. I love that dry wit of Frankie's there. You know, he always had those little zingers, you know? Frankie snaps his fingers, the bedroom door pops open, 3 beautiful girls come waltzing out wearing bikinis, right? I thought Louis was gonna start crying right there, man. Huh? They're friends of Frankie's. He told them if they hung out with us for the night, he'd introduce them to Bruce Springsteen. I didn't even know he knew Bruce Springsteen, man. Oh, he does it. Oh, I get it. All right. It's pretty funny. Anyways, it's a great party, man. Champagne, cocaine. Oh, man. Frankie got these porno tapes, right? Nice porno tapes, like warm everybody up. The nice ones, man. The kind with like stories in them and stuff. Oh, man. One of them was great. What was it about? It was like, wait a minute. Let me tell you. It's a girl, right? It's a girl. She's in her house. She's ironing her clothes. There's a knock on the door. She goes, who is it? Guy outside goes, it's the milkman. I have something for you, right? So this guy comes in, right? I don't think it was a real milkman or nothing, right? Comes in. They start doing it right on the ironing board, right there, right? Very erotic, very, very sensual and very hot, right? So they do it. Finally, the guy, he leaves, right? She goes back to ironing. Another knock on the door. She goes, who is it? Guy outside goes, UPS, I have something for you, right? This guy comes in, he's carrying a box like this, right? He's got this box, brings it in, she opens it up, his dick's inside, right? Oh, shit. I saw that dick, man, I couldn't believe it. I never would have guessed it in a million years, you know? Anyways, they do it. Finally, he leaves, takes his dick with him, and, she goes back to ironing. She's kind of tired now, right? She's kind of ironing slow, right? There's another knock on the door. She goes, who is it? Right, kind of tired now. Who is it, right? No answer. She goes to the door, see who's out there. She looks out. There's nobody out there. She looks down, Joey. There's a dog out there, right? The dog comes in her house, starts licking her feet, licking her legs. I can't watch it, man. I'm like this, right? I mean, what am I gonna tell a priest in confession, right? I'm like this, right? So I'm sitting there. I'm there with this girl. She's watching the whole thing, right? One of the babes we picked up, right? She's watching the whole thing. And I looks at her and I goes, this stuff turn you on? She goes, sure, why not? Like it's the most normal thing in the whole world, right? Rest of the night, I'm checking myself for fleas. You know what I'm saying, Joe? I'm like, right? I mean, where's she been, right? It's the 90s, man. You gotta watch out. Great party, though, man. Hey, I'm in heaven. I'm sitting there and I'm thinking to myself, I'm doing everything I love to do in the whole world. I'm sitting on a couch with a babe. I'm watching TV. I'm eating clam dip with a Ripple potato chip. I'm smoking joints, I'm snorting coke, I'm drinking shots of Jack Daniels, I'm chasing them with glasses of champagne mixed with Heineken, right? I'm sitting there, man, I'm thinking to myself, this is civilized, you know what I'm saying? It doesn't get any better than this, man. This is the top, man. I'm sitting there, and I got depressed, man. You know why? Because I looked over at Louis, and I thought to myself, he's never gonna have it like this for the rest of his life. Guys get married, they never have any fun anymore, man. He's never gonna live again. I mean, I'm gonna call him up 6 months from now. I swear, Joey, I'll say to him, Louie, let's go out, let's play some pool or something, right? And he'll be like, I don't know, I think I'm gonna like go up to the mall with my wife, look for towels and sheets, right? It's like he's had one towel, one sheet for 25 years, now he needs new towels and sheets. Who puts those ideas inside a guy's head, man? You know who. You know fucking who. So me and Frankie, we're partying, right? We're playing all those great party games, you know, like who can blow the most coke, right? Who can make his nose bleed first? Yeah. Who can drink the most shots? Who can see double first? We're getting completely twisted, right? Wasted, just blown into the ground, man. Like emergency room time, right? We're just sitting there, you know, ugh. You know, like when you're like this close to puking and you don't puke. You know, when it's nice like that, you know, everything's moving. You just got like, you're on a giant roller coaster. You're just going like this. You know what I mean? Oh man, it was so nice. You know how you can tell when you're really roasted? It's when you can't feel the end of your nose and you forget your name at the same time. We just sit there, we were just burnt out, man. I looks over, Louie's making out with the girl he's sitting with, right? This Angela. Next thing we know, he's going in the bedroom with her. Hey, it's okay. He's not married yet, right? He's normal, he's got hormones. So I go into the kitchen, because I'm hungry. Whenever I do lewds, I always get hungry, you know? So I'm in the kitchen, I'm frying up these steaks. Whole trick to frying steaks when you're doing lewds, Joey, is like keeping your face out of frying pan, you know what I'm saying? Just like, I'm just like, oh shit. The dog girl is helping me out. She's pulling my head out of the frying pan. Like, up boy, up, up. So I'm in there like for 10 minutes, that's all. This Angela comes tearing out of the bedroom. She goes, you gotta do something about your friend in there, right? So me and Frankie, we go barreling into the bedroom. Louis sitting in the middle of the bedroom floor, shit-faced, crying his eyes out. I changed my mind. I don't want to get married. I'm going, hey, Louie, you got to get married, okay? They already hired the hall and everything, man, okay? Your grandmother made lasagna for like 400 people. You got to get married, okay? He said, I don't care. I'm in love with her. Who's her? Angela. He's in love with this Angela now, right? All of a sudden, I smells my steaks burning, right? So we all go running into the kitchen. The whole kitchen, Joey, is all like fire, right? It's like all different kinds of fire, like burning everything up. So we're like, we're throwing champagne on it, we're throwing beer on it, we're like anything. The place, we finally get the fire out, it stinks, it smells, there's a mess. Frankie comes in the middle of the room. Frankie, he's so funny, man. He walks into the middle of the room, he just goes, fuck the fucking party, man, the fucking party's fucked. Right? Where does he come up with those lines, man? Out of the blue, he said, he's such a fucking comedian. He should be on TV, I'm telling you, man. Anyways, I says, look, the party's not over yet. So we go down to the new McDonald's, right? I mean, you're gonna go to a nice place, go to a nice place, right? We walks in with the girls. There's four bikers sitting over here having dinner, right? Okay, fine, great, we'll leave them alone, all right? We go over here, we sit over here, right? Louis, he's not eating, because he's like paralyzed with love. So he's just sitting there staring at Angela, right? Just like this, right? Flies buzzing in out of his mouth. Frankie, he's not eating, because every time he gets near any guys, like biker type of guys, like this little vein on the side of his head starts to throb, right? So he's not, I'm eating. I'm in a McDonald's, I'm gonna eat, right? I mean, how many chances do you get? So I'm sitting there, I'm eating. And one of the girls, she's screwing around. She finally gets one of those ketchup things, those ketchup pack thing. I don't even know what you call them. She takes it, she squishes it. The ketchup goes way up in the air, comes down, goes all over Frankie's clothes, all over his shirt, all over Frank. She starts laughing like a hyena, Joey. Like, this is the funniest thing she ever saw in her whole life, squirting ketchup on some guy, right? All the girls, they all start laughing hysterical. They all think this is so funny, right? The bike is over here. They see what happens. They all start laughing, okay? The guy that runs the McDonald's, the manager guy, he sees what happens. He starts laughing. Everybody's working there. They all start laughing. Everybody in the building is laughing at Frankie here, right? Great, let's make an atom bomb while we're at it. Right? Go, Frankie, listen, man, listen. Let's go out. Let's get some fresh air, okay? He goes, in a minute. He stands up, Joey. He walks over to the biggest fucking guy sitting over here, right? The guy's not even a human being. He's like a piece of the mountain is sitting over here, right? He's got a shaved head. He's got a tattoo of like Jesus or Satan or some fuck on his head. He's got a ring through his nose, big bushy beard. He's just sitting there going, la, 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 like this, right? Frankie walks right up to him, Joe. He walks right up, he goes, yo, chief, you lose this? And he's got one of those ketchup things in his hand, right? And he squishes it, goes pfft, pfft, all over the guy's face, right? Pfft, like this, right? Before the guy can even shake his head, Frankie's like, bang, 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 boom, 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 bang, beating the living shit out of this guy, right? Fortunately, I thought ahead. I picked up a trash can, one of those Ronald McDonald trash cans. I start smashing to the guy sitting next to him, right? So I'm hitting this guy with a trash can. Louis comes racing over, falls on one of the guys. The manager comes running out with a fire extinguisher, starts spraying me in the ear with a fire extinguisher, right? Like I started it or something, right? Frankie runs over the counter, goes in the back, gets a big pot full of that hot French fry grease, comes running back, splashes it all over these guys. Me, Frankie, Louis, we run out into the parking lot, we jump into my car, right? My Frankie's trying to start my car. My car never fucking starts, right? He's trying to start it. I'm praying to God, God, please, please, get us out of here. Get us out of here. Louis is hanging out the back door of the car. He's got the door wide open. He's hanging out. He's going, Angela! Angela! I'm going, Louis, get inside the car. Close the door, get inside. And that mountain guy, like nothing even happened to him, Joey. He just stands up like this. Starts walking toward a car, right? Right through the plate glass window at a McDonald's, man. Like this, right? We're just about to take off. He reaches out, grabs Louis' leg. Louis grabs me around the neck of the front seat. We take off, we're pulling this whale all over the parking lot, right? And Louis, I don't know if he did it on purpose, man, or what. He just turns around, he pukes all over the guy's head, right? He let go of a men, man. Louis passes out, falls in the back seat. We slam the door shut, we take off out of there like a bat out of hell. It was fucking great, man. It was so fucking great. And you know what was really great, Joey? You know what was like really like the icing on the gravy, man? It was like, no, listen, man. All the action finishes, right? And we're driving. Frankie's driving. He's not driving that fast now. He's doing about, you know, 85, 75, 85, right? We're about 5 miles away. Frankie's like, nothing even happened. I turns to Frankie. I says, Frankie, what'd you start all that stuff for, right? I mean, we could have gotten killed back there. He doesn't even look at me, Joey. You know what he said? He says, sometimes you gotta spit in the devil's eye just to make sure you're alive. Right? Right? I looks at Louis passed out in the back seat. I looks at Frankie driving the car. I thinks, yeah, man. Yeah, this guy knows what he's talking about, man. This guy will never cop out, man. This guy will never get married. No surrender, man. No fucking surrender. We drove all the way out to the beach. Me and Frankie, we made like a little fire on the beach, a little campfire. Smoked up the whole half pound of the pot. We stayed up all night long, man. We didn't even talk. It was like the most beautiful night of my whole life, man. Sun comes up, right? Sun comes up. Louis falls out of the backseat of the car. He comes out down to the beach, right? He goes, I have to be at the church at 10 a.m. He's got like puke all over him. He wants to go to church. So we take him, we stick him in the backseat, we start driving to the church. We run out of gas about a mile down the road, right? We got there, a little late, around 12:30 or something. So yeah. So they got to postpone it a little bit, you know, it's okay. It's all right. You got to postpone it to next Saturday. But listen, Joey, next Friday night, okay? We're going to have another little surprise stag for Louis. Don't tell him, all right? But wait a second. Joey, if you want to come, right, you can. But no girls, because too much fucking trouble.